Good morning, everyone. 皆さん、おはようございます。Welcome to our regular Sunday service. Some of you might be wondering why we have a joint today. Well, it's because it's Mother's Day. Happy Mother's Day, everyone, to the mothers out there. And so I figured the Japanese-speaking people as well, if we hold it as we normally would, it would be at 11:30, and then that might get into brunch so I figured we'll do together at 10:30, then whoever is going out for brunch could all go out for brunch. So, 本日の朝礼法座は合同礼拝となっています。それは母の日ということであり、まあ、日本語のいつもの時間だったり11時半からということで、まあ、よく母の日ランチ旅に行ったりされる方がおられると思いますので、まあ、今日合同礼拝とさせていただきます。まず、母の日、お母様の皆様に、おめでとうございます。We'll begin this morning's service with a moment of silent meditation, followed by the recitation of the name of the Buddha or the 念仏。それでは黙想と念仏で今日のお参りを始めたいと思います。よろしくお願いします。
Namandavs.
Next, we're going to read together our pledge. Actually, there's some copies on the back table that could I ask you to hand that out to me? It's also on the screen for those. Can you read that?Too small? Hiroko-on might have to hand out copies of it for you, for those who are here. 英語と日本語で、私たちの誓いをいただきたいと思います。Thank you. Thank you. Our pledge. Breaking out of my shell, I shall carefully share a warm smile and speak gentle words, just like the kind Buddha.Not becoming lost in my greed, anger, and ignorance, I shall be open-minded and act accordingly, just like the calm and peaceful Buddha. Not putting myself first, I shall share in the joy and sadness of others, just like the compassionate Buddha. Realizing the gift of life we have received, I shall live each day to its fullest, like the Buddha who continues to emancipate all.それでは、日本語でこれを、同じちょっと待ってください。日本語で私たちの誓いをいただきたいと思います。画面に映っています。ちょっと待ってください。 私たちの誓い、一つ、自分の殻に閉じこもることなく、穏やかな顔と優しい言葉を大切にします。微笑み語りかける仏様のように。一つ、むさぼり、怒り、愚かさに流されず、しなやかな心と振る舞いを心がけます。心安らかな仏様のように。一つ、自分だけを大事にすることなく、人と喜びや悲しみを分かち合います。慈悲に満ち満ちた仏様のように。一つ、生かされていることに気づき、日々に精一杯努めます。人々の救いに尽くす仏様のように。ナマナマス、ナマナマス。Next, we'll have the sutra chanting, and we're going to be chanting the Junirai, which you'll find on page 63 of your purple seitan. 63 ページの Junirai を一緒にいただきたいと思います。もしくは画面にも映っています。ナマナブス、ナマナブス、ナマナブス、ナマナブス。
Yeah.
そ今代を現地上下全音上上目内座大い座上女性の子が将来未なそ自母将来所無心権現人ずしやな戦後尊厳上宮業高賀将来みなそ小宇無常無我土薬尿水が無念よろ一周戦も無名寺高賀将来みそ一尊不せず無悪名薬無尿に悪の不主に自信教一尊高賀将来みそ依存無量無勉強薬小衆悪事事義法上不耐死もない高賀将来みなそ賀せず依存具独自修善無遍如来水小逆前後小上者衛生修如小以後那 snowman loves, snowman loves, snowman loves. Please join me in reading the English translation of the Junior A, and you'll find that in your seiten on page 70. Twelve Adorations, Junior A translation. Before Amida Buddha, whom Deva heavenly beings worship, I humble myself in deepest reverence. In his wondrous land of bliss, surrounded is he by countless bodhisattvas. His golden form shines forth, pure like the king of Mount Sumeru. His practice of truth is steadfast, like an elephant's pace. His eyes radiate like pure blue lotus blossoms. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. His countenance is perfectly pure and round like the full moon. His majestic light shines like a thousand suns and moons. His voice is like heavenly drum, yet like a heavenly bird, Kokila. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. Avalokiteshvara wears upon his crown the image of Amida adorned with many precious jewels. He subdues the arrogance of demons and heretics. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. Incomparable, vast, and pure, his virtues are, clearly extending like vast open space, his acts freely benefiting all. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. Bodhisattvas from the ten quarters and countless Maras, demons, always venerate him. He dwells with vow power for the sake of all beings. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. In the golden treasure pond where the lotus flowers bloom, established with goodness is a wondrous throne, where reigns the Buddha like the king of the mounts. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. From the ten quarters, bodhisattvas come, revealing wondrous powers. They attain blissful state. Honoring his face, they offer eternal homage. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. All things are transient without self, like the moon on water, lightning, shadow, or the dew. The Dharma cannot be expressed by words, the Buddha proclaimed. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. No words of evil are in his land, no fear of evildoers, nor evil paths. With sincere heart, all beings worship him. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. His land of infinite expediencies is without degenerate things or wicked beings. Upon rebirth, non-retrogressive bodhi does one attain. Thus I prostrate myself before Amida Buddha. Thus have I praised the virtues of Amida Buddha. Boundless are they like the water of the sea. Upon receiving these pure and good qualities, may all beings be reborn into his land. Namo Amida Buddha. Namo Amida Buddha. Once again, welcome everyone to our service. And I'm going to begin by reading, I'm going to be speaking both English and Japanese. And this morning's Dharma talk is not going to be a Dharma talk. It's going to be a little bit of a session. And I'll explain about that in just a second. 本日の法話はですね、法話ではなく、皆さんと一緒に、少し考えたいことがあります。それを後ほど説明します。So, of course, today is Mother's Day, and we gather here for our mothers, or one of the reasons we're here is to honor memories of our mothers. And I'd like to begin by reading a passage from what we call the Gowasan of Shinran Shonin, or the poems that Shinran wrote in his latter years. And this one is about mothers. It says, as a child seeks comfort from his mother, Should sentient beings on the Buddha meditate? Today and in not too distant tomorrow, the Tathagata they shall without doubt perceive. As a child seeks comfort from his mother, should sentient beings on the Buddha meditate? Today and in the not too distant tomorrow, the Tathagata they shall without doubt perceive. What this is saying, of course, is that we turn to the Buddha very much like a child turns to the mother. Okay, so the very special relationship between mother and children. 本日のご参題は親鸞聖人のゴハさんからっていうことで、まあ要約すると、この子供が母に、愛を求めるように、私たちも、阿弥陀様をそのように考えると、いずれ お釈迦様如来と一つになるという、ご和さんなんですね。でこれはもちろんこの母と子供のことを例えとして阿弥陀様と私たちの関係を表しているんですね。And this relationship between mother and child is very unique. And I wanted to share, actually it was my father who said when he was in university, he was invited to a house for Thanksgiving. I believe this was when he was in Ontario. And so when he went there, I think it was he and my uncle Matt, when they were still students. And they went for Thanksgiving dinner. And as I guess many families, they would gather for Thanksgiving dinner, and they invited my father and my uncle. And when they got there and they began eating the meal, and my father said, to be honest, he wasn't too keen on the turkey. He found it very dry, right? But he said that the children said, oh, there's nothing like mom's cooking, right? There's nothing like mom's cooking. And my father realized at that time that his perception was very different from the children's perception. And of course, that's because they were receiving the meal with love, right? Whereas to my father, he was only using his taste buds to receive the meal. So, 今説明したように、この母と子供の関係って特別な関係があるわけなんですね。で、私の父もまだ大学時代の頃の話を以前したことがあって、それはこのある、まあ、私の父と叔父がユニバーシティ・トロントに行ってたわけなんです。で、Thanksgiving にある家庭に呼ばれ、そこに行ったらですね、まあ、父から言わすと、ターキーが非常にドライだったっていうんですね。でも、やっぱり、子供たち、その家の子供たちは、いやー、やっぱりお母さんのターキーが一番だって言ってた。それはその時父が、まあ後でだと思うんですけど、気づいたことが、やっぱりこの受け方がですね、違ってたと。自分とこの子供たちがね、やっぱり子供たちはお母さんの愛情をもらってたわけなんです。で、父はただ下で味を見てただけなんですね。ですからそこの違いがあったという話が以前私の父がして、それをこのいつも母のことを考えるとそう思うんですね。やはり私たち母とのスペシャル特別な関係がある。そこでですね、今日はですね、皆さんに一つこの内観っていうセラピー法があるんですけど、これをちょっとほんの少し、皆さんと一緒にしたいと思うんです。この内観っていうのはある浄土真宗の御門徒さんが、始めたセラピーであって、基本的に3つの質問によって成り立つわけなんです。で、まず でよく使われるのはこのお母さんというテーマで使われることがあるんです。でまず一つの質問、ね、が、私は、まあ、この場合お母さんに使うと私や母からいただいたことでリストを作ってもらいたい、自分の頭の中で、okay? So、what I wanted to do, so as I was mentioning this special relationship with mother and children、I wanted to today, what we're going to do, as I mentioned, it's not going to be quite a Dharma talk, it's going to be a little different、I'm going to share with you、this、therapy called Nikon therapy, which is、inner reflection, okay? And it's based on three questions. And a very common exercise that they use is an exercise on mothers. So the first question, and we're going to contemplate for a few minutes, is、the question you have to ask to yourself is, what have I received from my mother?、Okay? So what I want you to do is make a mental list within your head.、we're going to sit for a few minutes quietly.And it could be something as dramatic as she gave birth to me, right? That's one thing you receive. But it can be all the little things that you can think of, okay? So we're going to sit quietly for a few minutes and you list up in your head what you have received from your mother.Okay, now we're going to go on to the second question. それでは次の質問に行きます。The next question is, what have I given to my mother? 私が母に何々を与えたこと。自分からお母さんに与えたこと。今度リストを考えてください。So spend a few minutes thinking, making a list in your head,of all the things that you have given to your mother. And it doesn't have to be materialistic. It can be something as simple as a smile or a hug. And now we're going to go to the third question, and that is, how have I inconvenienced my mother? Okay, how have I inconvenienced my mother? So you make a list of things that you've done that maybe have inconvenienced your mother. 3番目の質問が、私が母にご迷惑をかけたこと。しばらく考えてください。Okay. How was that? Which list was the easiest for you to list up? First one. Interesting, isn't it? I also noticed something else within myself is that the receiving one, I tended to think of back to my childhood and all the things I received as childhood. Whereas the giving one is much more close, well, with aging parents, we end up thinking more about the stuff we give more recently, right? And then, of course, the inconvenience ones. So what this shows us is that we receive far more than we can ever give. Okay, so on this Mother's Day, it's a wonderful exercise because sometimes it's easy for us to forget this fact, but in fact that we receive so much more than we can ever give. And when we listen to the teachings of the Buddha, again, it is a reminder to us when we hear this, the phrase of Namo Amida Butsu, it is in fact saying that I take refuge in the infinite life that sustains me, okay, and the infinite light that sustains me. So it is reflecting on the fact that I receive so much, and in gratitude, this word or the six character word, Namo Amida Butsu, comes out. Speaking of getting in contact with the oneness of life or the wowness of life, I need to share with you something that happened this past Friday. How many of you saw the Northern Lights Friday night? You missed it. Well, so my wife and I, we heard on the news that, you know, possibly we might be able to see it. So we actually went to Gary Point on Friday night. And we got there just before 9 o'clock. So it was still kind of light out to the west. And we parked our car. There's lots of parking space. And we went to Gary Point, and we were watching for a while. And as it got darker, we were able to see this sort of whitish, almost looked like a cloud at night. And we thought, oh, maybe that's the Northern Lights, maybe, could be. And you know, my wife, she figured out, or she had known from previously, that you can actually take pictures with your camera. You set it on the night setting and then you have an extended exposure. And then, so At first, I couldn't figure that out. So she's looking at this thing, and she says, see, you could actually see colors when you look, take a picture with your camera or with your phone, right? And so I finally figured out how to do it myself, and I started to go, whoa, this is really interesting. You can actually see colors in this, right? So we decided, we were there about an hour, I guess, and then we were deciding whether to go home or not, but I started to figure out the camera. I said, no, no, we should stay a little longer. And so we stayed, and I just wanted to, hang on, let me just. I wanted to share this with you. Can you see that? This is Gary Point on. This is what it looked like. And all of a sudden, the skies just sort of opened up, and it was like we were rained down with colors, and you could actually see it with your naked eyes even. But it was quite the thing. And it was funny because, especially when, so it was like we were at the epicenter, like it was coming right down on top of us. And all of a sudden, and this happened rather quickly, within a span of seconds, like it just suddenly turned from this whitish color to this dome of colors. And you could hear collectively through, and by this time, Gary Point was filled with people. The parking lot was full, and there's line up all the way down Chatham Street, people trying to get in. But when this happened, you could hear the whole Gary Point, everybody going, whoa! and it was quite moving. And you one felt really connected with something that was beyond our daily life. And whether you call this getting connected with sort of whether you call this getting connected with the universe or whatever you want to call it, this wow, it is an expression. And there is a retired he used to be the bishop of BCA. Kubose sensei, Reverend, not Kubose. It wasn't Kubose. The former bishop of BCA, he used to say that the Nembutsu, Namu Amida Butsu, is getting in touch with the wowness of life. And so when everybody's going, wow, it was really getting in touch with the wowness of life. And in fact, it can be something like that, or very simple, something like expressing or realizing the connection of oneness when we think about it, reflect about our mothers. And so as we do reflect on our mothers, we put our hands together. Ah, I forgot Japanese. 日本語で説明するのを忘れました。先ほどのですね、ノーザンナイツのことなんですけど、この間金曜日のゲリーポイントパークで撮った写真なんですが、非常に感動して、もう言葉が出ないぐらいみんなで一斉にゲリーポイントに大勢の人が集まってたんですけど、一斉にみんながわーっていう声がですね、これが、いわばお念仏も同じなんですよ。この宇宙と一つになったっていう感じをしたのも、お念仏はこの生かされている、生きとし生きる命、また光、阿弥陀様の光と一つになられた時の感動なんですね。で、これはもちろんこういうイベントを、通して、考えさせることもあれば、自分のお母さんに対する感動、この内観の通してですね、お母さんのことをもう一回振り返ってみると、ああやはりそこには自分の命というものは いろんなものに支えられ生かされている命があるということですね。今日皆さんに少しばかり母の日に紹介させていただきました。 So I'd like to close this session with a recitation of the 念仏. So if I can ask you, please join me in 合唱。南無阿弥陀仏、南無阿弥陀仏、南無阿弥陀仏。Thank you very much. So this will conclude our regular Sunday service for Mother's Day. And again, happy Mother's Day. And I hope you will have an enjoyable rest of the day. これをもちまして、本日の条例法座を、終わりにしたいと思います。皆さん、ぜひ良い母の日を送られるようにということで、coming events. So this coming Wednesday, Wednesday night we'll be showing the movie Fancy Dance about the young man who has to take over his father's temple, and so he has to go into practice for a little while. Unfortunately, the quality is not that great. This is the only version I could find with English subtitles, but it's definitely something you don't want to miss. It'll give you a new insight into temple life. And as I've mentioned in our programs, you'll never take a look at me in the same light again after watching this. So I highly recommend, if you're able to join us, Wednesday night at 7 o'clock, Fancy Dance. Okay. It was directed by the same person who directed Shall We Dance? That became a very famous movie, but this is one of his earlier works. Fancy Dance, yes. And then next 2 weeks, I will be away, but Roy Sensei will be here to conduct services. So there'll be only services in English. I'm off to Ontario to help out at the Toronto Temple for the next 2 weeks. Okay, so thank you very much. 日本語で、これからの行事なんですけど、今度は水曜日にですね、ファンシーダンスという、シャルリーダンスを監督、同じ人、スオなんだったっけ、マサなんとかだったと思うんですけど、監督した、作品であり、とても面白い作品なので、ぜひ、時間があれば水曜日の夜7時からファンシーダンスという映画を上映します。そしてこの次の2週間は日本語のお勤めはございません。というのは、私がちょっと出張して、ロイ先生が代わりにしますけど、ロイ先生は英語だけなので、英語のお参りしかありません。というわけで、皆さんどうもありがとうございました。Thank you to everybody who joined by Zoom, and enjoy the rest of your day.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you very much, Sensei. And happy Mother's Day to all the mothers out there.
Just want to see something. If you hit start video, what happens?